Hello guys, a very good morning to all of you. So myself, Neha Gupta, your mentor for current affairs. And this is the Morning Tales for February 9, 2021. And I hope that you are all doing very hard work to crack this examination. And this series is definitely going to help you out. So if you know any of your friends who are preparing for the RBI Grade B, SEBI, NABARD, any other examination related to the banking sector, then you can share this lecture with them as well so that they can also clear the examination. On that note, let's begin this video, and the people who are coming for the first time can subscribe and hit this bell notification because we are going to upload many useful sessions for your RBI Grade B preparation. So if you don't want to miss them out, then guys, do subscribe and hit this bell notification. Also, you can join this Telegram group. Here we provide you with the latest updates about the exam, as well as you can enjoy the free quizzes that we provide. Also, you can ask your query. If you have any query related to the examination, you can ask us on this channel. You will also have your seniors who have attempted the examination, so they will also help you to resolve your queries, basic general queries related to the examination. So if you have any query, then don't wait, just join this channel and ask your queries directly from your mentor. Guys, so this is something that we have for you guys. So this is the new latest offering from our side, the crash course of RBI Grade B, which has phase 1 plus phase 2 complete, and the price is 14,999. So you can go to the website and have this, you can buy this crash course for your RBI Grade B 2020 to 2021 examination. In this specific course, we have all the revision sessions that we are taking on YouTube as well as on Learnist platform, that is our web browser for the, that is our Infinity platform. So all the lectures that we are taking specifically for your revision are provided in this course. So if you want to buy, you can go to our website and buy this course. Okay, so here is our first question. With which Indian state has Switzerland agreed to share their expertise in the field of skill training, tourism, dairying, etc.? So basically, recently an arrangement or an agreement has been set up between the Switzerland, the country named Switzerland, as well as an Indian state. Now, which state is it? We have Punjab, Maharashtra, Madhya Pradesh, Haryana and Gujarat. So the right answer here is Haryana. With Haryana, Switzerland has decided to share its expertise, share its knowledge in the field of skill training, tourism and dairy. Apart from this, both parties have also decided to explore the possibilities of cooperation in culture, teacher, student field, in the field of education, in the field of cultural exchange, etc., etc., in order to strengthen the bilateral relationship between these two parties. Now, why is Haryana so special for Switzerland? The reason behind this is that 10% of Switzerland's business in India is from Haryana. So this is a very big proportion if you see India as the whole country. So from India, only one state is contributing 10% towards the business of Switzerland. Therefore, Haryana is one of the most important state for Switzerland, and this partnership has taken place. So that's all for this question. But my question from you is, you have to tell me the capital, currency and the prime minister of Switzerland. So these are three questions that I expect from you guys. Which state has introduced a system of issuing unique 16-digit unique code to mark all kinds of land holdings in the state? So we have Andhra Pradesh, Karnataka, Odisha, Maharashtra and Uttar Pradesh, out of which the right answer is option E. So Uttar Pradesh has launched this unique 16-digit unique code that will be provided to each and every piece of land so that the identification of the land can be made easy and the land disputes can be resolved. So it's the unique system this 16 digit Unicode will be given to all kinds of land, be it agriculture, be it residential, or may it be the commercial land. So all kinds of land will be given a 16 digit unique code, and this code will help in resolving the land disputes. Guys, do you remember that recently Uttar Pradesh has also launched a campaign to resolve the land disputes and prevent people from getting duped by the land mafias? So what is the name of that campaign? If you can recall the name, then mention it in the comment section below. So this is your task, that you have to mention the name of the campaign launched by Uttar Pradesh very recently. So this is again an important question that I'm asking you. Apart from this, at the center level, we have the Swamitva scheme for the land records, under which the land records will be provided, will be kept digitally, as well as the land card will be provided to the beneficiaries, will be provided to the landholders, so that the landholders, which are majorly the farmers, so that they can use their land as an asset by virtue of that land card that they will get from the government. So basically, the basic purpose of launching Swamitva is to resolve the land disputes, as well as to help the farmers and the rural area people to get the benefit of the land as their asset, so that they can monetize their land asset whenever they are in need. So these are the twofold purposes that the Swamitva scheme aims to serve. So these are some information that you should keep in mind related to the land records. Next is, which state has launched Chief Minister's Water Conservation Program for restoring the irrigation capacity by repairing the water sources? You have Rajasthan, Bihar, Maharashtra, Chhattisgarh and Jharkhand. Which state has launched this Chief Minister Water Conservation Program? The right answer is Maharashtra. Now, why is this program launched, or what is so special about this program? The unique point about this program is that it aims to restore or repair the existing water sources. According to the government of Maharashtra, the water sources are enough in the state, although we need to build additional water sources, but the one that we have in existence should also need to be repaired, so that the water restoration can be done successfully. Basically, water resources like the lakes or whatever kind of water resources are there which need maintenance or repair, that will be done under this program, so that water can be used for irrigation purpose. That's the whole purpose of this scheme, to repair the existing water sources so that the water can be restored in them, and from there it can be used in the irrigation of lands. That's all for this scheme. Next, where will India's first geothermal field development project be developed? So a tripartite agreement has also been signed by ONGC, Oil and Natural Gas Corporation. So ONGC has also signed an agreement for development of this first geothermal field development project. Now, where will it be developed? You have Arunachal Pradesh, Ladakh, Odisha, Andaman and Nicobar, and Jammu and Kashmir in the options. Out of these, the right answer is Ladakh. So in Ladakh, this first of its kind or first ever geothermal field project will be developed, under which geothermal energy will be used to produce clean energy. So what is the purpose? Why is this project being developed? The purpose is to generate the geothermal energy and put that energy into clean energy, or use that energy to have the clean energy. So this is one initiative towards the renewable energy target that the government of Ladakh has taken. And do you remember that I told you about the agreement that has been signed? So the agreement has been signed by ONGC for development of this field with the Ladakh administration. So these are the organizations or the parties involved in the development of this field, which is going to be developed in three phases. Now, this is something that you should not remember because it will cram your mind. Such kind of facts are not important. How many phases are there? Until or unless it is a very important project, you don't have to remember the phases. Now, guys, since this is an agreement signed between the Ladakh administration and ONGC, I would like to ask you a question, and that question is the governor of Ladakh as well as Jammu and Kashmir. So tell me the governors in the comment section below. Which country has which country has announced to develop world's largest offshore wind power complex? We have Japan, Spain, UK, South Korea and China in the options. Tell me the right answer. If you know the answer, then you can write it in the comment section below. But let me tell you that the answer of this question is South Korea. So South Korea has allocated $43 billion for developing this world's largest offshore wind power complex. What would be the capacity of this wind power complex? It would be 8.2 gigawatt. And at present, the current world's largest offshore wind power complex is owned by United Kingdom. And the power of that is, capacity of that is 1.2 gigawatt. So these are some of the facts that you have to remember. The current world's largest offshore wind power complex is owned by United Kingdoms. Okay. Now, guys, what is the name of that power complex? That you have to tell me in the comment section below. Bahut easy name hai. If you search it, then you will easily find it. Do find it and mention it in the comment section below. What is the name of that offshore wind power complex? Now, as far as this question is concerned, we have discussed every important fact related to the question, apart from one thing which is conceptual, and that thing is, what is the offshore wind power complexes? The offshore wind power complexes are those complexes that are located in the water bodies, like we have oceans, seas. So the wind power plants that are located inside the water bodies are called the offshore wind power complexes. And that's all for this question. Do find out the name of the current world's largest offshore wind power complex. And remember that South Korea has announced to complete this project of building this world's largest offshore wind power complex, which will have a capacity of 8.2 gigawatts. Which bank signed an MOU with MUFG Bank of Japan for collaboration towards catering to the banking requirements of Japanese corporate present in India? So we have Karnataka Bank, SBI, Punjab National Bank, ICICI Bank and Axis Bank in the option. Which one is the right answer? The right answer is ICICI Bank. Guys, I don't think that I need to explain what this MOU will do, because that is being explained by the question itself. That is to fulfill the banking requirements and provide the keys to the Japanese corporates. This MOU has been signed between ICICI Bank and the MUFG Bank of Japan, which is one of the premier banks in Japan. Now, I remember that India's first of its kind facility has been launched by ICICI Bank to facilitate foreign companies to operate in India. So can you guys name that facility? It's Infinite India. So I have named it for you guys. So it's Infinite India. It is the banking facility that will be offered by ICICI Bank to the foreign companies so that they can come in India and operate seamlessly, effortlessly. So that is another feature, another offering from the ICICI Bank that you should remember, because it was launched very recently. Apart from this, there is one mobile application, InstaFX. So both these things I have discussed in Morning Tales earlier. So if you remember that InstaFX is the mobile application for facilitating easy foreign exchange. So these are two initiatives along with this MOU that ICICI Bank has taken to provide ease of doing business in India to the foreign companies, and this MOU is particularly for the Japanese corporate. Now that's all the information ends here, but my question from you is remaining. And the question is the tagline of ICICI Bank. Tell me that in the comment section below. And here this video also ends. I hope that you have enjoyed it, and if you have, then do share it and like this video. Thank you so much for watching the video.